we'd had a few areas and a few queries around the top end of Grange Road and Grange Road West in terms of how we could improve the area. And the reason I've included it in here is 12 months down the line of this neighbourhood working, just an example really of how it's come together quite well in terms of, we had initial meetings with some of the traders to talk through what were highlighted issues in relation to antisocial behaviour, in relation to some of the waste issues, various things, and how we can look at moving forward. Been tremendous support from the departments internally and externally in terms of the waste environment team, enforcement team, the antisocial behaviour team. And we had a second meeting about a month ago to talk through where each of the actions are up to. And we're making progress to improve the area. But what struck me is the support from public sector with the traders has worked really well. It wasn't a meeting that you sit and people say this is what's wrong and what the council's going to do about it. There's been a kind of joint partnership. So for example, in terms of the waste bins, there's been support from waste and environment in terms of how we can look at developing them to be more appropriate and support from the council. But McDonald's are going to come in and sponsor them and involve them where they're going to be positioned.
Yes, McDonald's, you've been mentioned. Please, if you're welcome.
I think the key point that came through is that nobody can really do it on their own. If you're going to be a real community, then everybody's going to play a part. And it's not only your pride, building some aspiration, which Dylan was talking about in the piece, that everybody can buy into. That, whether it's residents, whether it's businesses, whether it's the council, whether it's the health organisations, etc. Everybody's got the same goal and everybody's got to play a part. And it's only by building those partnerships and gaining support that whether it's coming through with a can do, will do, support attitude, that's the main focus. So we do as the resident businesses up on the Grange Road really appreciate the support that Dylan's helped us with.
The next step from that is building in the Chamber of Commerce. Came to the last meeting and we're going to look at hosting some events in the town centre. Again, hopefully utilising some of the empty shops, do some further engagement with traders to just look at how we can improve the area.
Just to ask that about the waste bins and the vendors, I've noticed almost daily now, black bags keep being in bad things. And at first it was just one, so then that was migrated to over the road.
The follow-up from that is the enforcement team are going to do a targeted piece of work on Grange Road West, reminding them of what they can and can't do, and the enforcement's around that, so that's going to be followed up. We talked about that at the last meeting, so I'll keep you updated.
Putting
the
bins there, Jim? Who do you think of putting the bins there? Sorry, the bags.
Go to mesh, if you like, the decision-making process that is going on here.
we want to find out about. So for example, in terms of early years, you know, we've touched on some bits, but what's the feedback in relation to current services? What are still the gaps in services? What are people receiving? What are they looking at improving? So that would be the next step, and that's approved tonight, would be for the group to look at what targeted pieces of work, in line with the proposals we've identified so far in terms of improving the environment. Again, that's things like that we've just talked through then, consulting with people. I think Mark will touch on that in some of his reports around that further research. A lot of the stuff that's come through over the last 12 months and previously is sometimes anecdotal, and it's finding out what is the aspect, but what we need to prioritise is how we want to target that. And then look at the recruitment of those community researchers in terms of, if we're looking at communicating with young people, can we get young people to do that sort of work? There's an organisation, for example, called 1419, who do a lot of work with young people in the Magenta houses. They might be someone that we recruit for a specific piece of work. That's the next stage to be thought through, and input from them, and that would be really key.
Right.
Appendix 4 is an overview of community projects that are in progress. This is just going to continue to be populated. And this covers some of the bits that kind of Andy and myself pick up that are outside the general committee business, but I think it's important for you to know. So that's just an update. That will continue to be maintained. One key one was the Safe in Town card for Birkenhead. One of the aspirations for the area where we've talked to put the handbook together, and we've talked to the community and we've talked to members, was in terms of how we improve the perception of the area, and that piece of work fits really clearly with that. So it's being followed through in terms of how we can have some safe venues in Birkenhead that a vulnerable adult or a vulnerable child or anyone feels they need to go, and looking at how we can get them geographically spread across the area. Wirral Met have been really keen and really supportive of this in terms of their students, how they can engage with it. The police are really supportive of it, and they're looking at they're supportive of how we roll this out. And some various specific organisations such as MedCap in how we get the promotion of it right and the communication of it right. So again, I'll keep you updated on that, but I think it'll be a key one really to help with one of the aspirations that was set out.
Yeah, it was not so much a question, but it was just really to mention. I think the work, Frank, that you started, and I hope it hasn't been lost, on identifying the spend within Birkenhead and trying to understand what outcomes we get for that spend. I think that is a vital piece of work. It's a difficult piece of work, but it is an essential piece of work. We hear so much today about we need fairness in the way funds are distributed. Unless we've done the homework and really understand where the money goes and what we get for it, we're not really in a position to make our case to argue for the funding that we've got.
Thank you. I was going to actually chip in when after Stuart's book to say that we have got this project, which I don't think we have anywhere else in the country. We're starting with that on preschool services to see how much the 16 national budgets spend in this area. Or specifically starting with that area. And I think to your point, Stuart, we will then hopefully move to a stage when we begin to understand what works in Birkenhead, whether those 16 commissioners might actually think of work together about how they might better spend their budget, whatever the size of the budget is. I was anxious not to keep talking from the chair. Thank you for that, Lois. This does knit together. Jean.
We did have a really positive meeting with children's services, because one of the issues always we come across is data sharing, and we met Frank and I met with the director of children's services, and they're pushing forward at the moment that in terms of the outcomes that have been achieved, but to improve the processes is how information that health visitors have got can be shared with schools, shared with parents, shared with communities. So we're looking at that as well. They're following that up on there. To make sure, because that could be, even though it's not a new development, can be included in this overall scheme.
Yeah, I'm just going to talk about the cost of like hospital or temporary hospital. Will all that go into that as well?
Mm-hmm. update on the 7 weeks project. That's an extension of what the police are doing. I was going to suggest it might be useful that they come to the next committee meeting to provide an update on where that's up to. It has broadened out and it'd be really interesting, I think, for people to know.
Well, certainly, I mean, given the business about how we make the town a better place and a safer place, it would be a major item on that agenda that's on the stage. All right, very good. Are we on to
the
next? There's a sort of question. How do we start to get the budgets on the table? Do you think it's an unfair question? Why haven't you decided to spend your budget on that way? What are your objectives? Make your label and then most effective, but we wouldn't be able to double think and show you. That's something very interesting. It would be very helpful for all services to have some of these basic questions asked. Not in a threatening way, because in genuine, we want to spend our whatever budget we have to get a certain desired outcome.
And will we be able to ask that question?
No.
Problem with what's been proposed here, not the idea of handing out money appalling measure which we need to get rid of. And I just am concerned that there's a large sum of money being asked to allocate here by a committee that includes Magenta. And I am a bit uncomfortable about agreeing this tonight and would suggest that we just pause this while we review this. For example, one question I would ask is, which we need to debate, I accept, could we use this money more effectively by helping those people that are on the receiving end, those Magenta tenants are on the receiving end that are evicted because they can't pay the bedroom tax. So I'm just a bit concerned about agreeing this tonight when I know this is going on, I'm sure not just in my ward, but in other parts of the constituency.
And in other housing estates. I mean, there clearly are scallywags way in arrears and just using this for their arrears that we prefer. When I visited Magenta 2 Fridays ago, there are a number of people who've never been in arrears and are now in arrears. And I think I agree with you, Phil, the idea that we should be handing out some 2,500 get rid of the rest of it, and total the regeneration of the town. And that's happening. So can we follow Phil's suggestion and withdraw this?
I agree.
Go back to Magenta?
Yes.
Is that agree?
Great.
Thank you very much.
Great.
There's a difference though, isn't there? Magenta having money, bless them, to spend on these projects, and they have to protect its budget by saying, you haven't paid your bedroom tax. And then nationally is also applied through about council tax. We could hardly expect Magenta to pay the council tax as well. Right? But there is an issue here of Phil's rights. We will take that away and go back, see whether Magenta listens to us, can we?
Great.
All right, thank you very much. Yes, great. Sorry we failed you, Jean. That proposal is accepted. Individual registration. Who is doing that? Dave. Very good.
What do you do, Jeff?
Would you like to come to a microphone?
Okay.
Properties where we haven't had any recent communication.
not be registered, so we should protect people's postal votes and proxy votes.
But let's assume that you send all this information out and you get almost no response. What's the next step then?
The vast majority, so 91% of are not required to respond. We will be spreading to the missing part of it. We will be sending a series of reminders, we will be sending canvases, and we will hopefully get the responses in.
Denise G. seems herself with the four members who wanted to review, and they will come back to us again. But our main concern was that the likelihood of people actually registering in the more deprived ports is less, and therefore the concentration of effort on getting those people signed up. But even so, the prediction was, I can't remember the figure of the two counties, the shortfall for a ward like Birkenhead,
and we have a CCD rejected, which is now just it's a stage after, isn't it, when it's not as successful the strategy as we had.
As in past, we will just have to continue pressing people to register as much as we can. We will use the availability of other council databases, but we will register people if they qualify to register. The fact that we may be behind the council tax payments, etc., doesn't say we can't. Where we can, we use databases to check the distribution and we can get as many people in as we can and build partners as well.
So the aim of it is anyway to do all this, to use canvas, to invite people to sign up, to use canvases to encourage people to sign up, but also then to use council data.
We have the LCE. Loans back in Birkenhead. How many of those loans did they check for the people on the register?